We are at Carter Stadium, Fort Worth, Texas. A champion versus champion game here in prime time. It's the Sun Belt Conference champions against the Big 12 champions, Arkansas State versus Oklahoma State. For Arkansas State, their first appearance ever in the Big Dance, but for the Sun Belt Conference, they are 2-3 all time in the first round of the BCS playoffs, pulling off numerous upsets twice as the number 32 seed. The Sun Belt Conference has upset the number 1 seed. This time around, though, the Sun Belt at number 30 going up against the Big 12 at number 3. For the Cowboys of Arkansas State, Mike Gundy and company, they have been one of the top teams in terms of BCS playoffs. They've been here 3 times. They've made it to the Final Four once and the Elite Eight twice. That is pretty good for Mike Gundy and his crew. For the Red Wolves, they're having to do it without head coach Hugh Freeze. He's already left to take the job at Ole Miss, the head coaching job, but his team still wants to make a rally here today. You're looking at the D-back McCray, and they're going to have to do their part if they want to try to slow down this Oklahoma State offense. We are winding down. We have this game at 8, and then coming up at 9 on the Deuce will be the 20th anniversary of the Mako Bowl Las Vegas. That's Boise State and Florida State in that one. We've already seen some great, exciting games. And Oklahoma State number 3 as part of the Oklahoma State bracket. And Arkansas State, they're going to be the ones to kick this one off. Ryan Applin is your starting quarterback, and that is not a good start if you're the Red Wolves. Taking a look at the Oklahoma State bracket, the winner of this game will move on to take on either Houston or Oklahoma in round number 2, so possibly a Bedlam rematch down the line. The only team from this bracket that has moved on is Virginia Tech, and that was over Penn State. And the second pass of the game, that's for Ryan Applin. He floats it incomplete, and Arkansas State already finds themselves in a hole. Third down and long here at the Armed Forces Bowl. Applin, quarterback sack. Down he goes. Way too easy on that opening drive for Oklahoma State. And in on the quarterback sack, that was number 89. Nigel Nicholas, defensive tackle. So quick 3-and-out. And very short punt will give the Cowboys, who have an awesome offense, great field position. Carter Stadium, Fort Worth, Texas. The Bell Helicopter Armed Forces Bowl. Great members of our military personnel and crew are here watching this one between the Sun Belt champs and the Big 12 champs. First play for the Cowboys. Brandon Whedon was looking for Justin Blackman, and it went incomplete. For Justin Blackman, he's already announced, hey, I'm ready to go to the NFL. So he knows that whatever game this team loses, it will be his last. He's determined to go out with 5 straight wins and bring a national championship home to Oklahoma State. The Cowboys are on the move. Third down and 2. Brandon Whedon. Incomplete. Inexplicably dropped by his wide receiver Isaiah Anderson. And so on 4th down and 2, Mike Gundy says, that is unacceptable and we are going to go for it. Out of the pistol for the Pokes. Whedon rolling out, has a wide open Justin Blackman for the first down at the 11. Sun Belt champions. They've done it before. 3-2 in first round games. That's an above 500 winning percentage for this conference. Whedon, end zone, incomplete. Lots of people making the trip from Oklahoma down here to Fort Worth, and quite a few people from Arkansas, from Jonesboro, made the trip as well for the Red Wolves. That's going to be a tackle by Arkansas State. That was the first handoff of the football game to Joseph Randall, and he is met at the line and tackled to third down and 10 for Whedon and company. Whedon takes it out of shotgun. That one is knocked away, incomplete, so they hold him. The Arkansas State Red Wolves do their job, and they hold him. That one was batted down by McCray for the Arkansas State Red Wolves. So fourth down, do they go for it again? No. They elect to kick it. Kick is away, and the kick is going to be good. So Quinn Sharp remains perfect from the 20 to 29-yard range. Oklahoma State was hoping for a touchdown after their defense did a great job, but Arkansas State's defense says, we're not going to let you do it. Eight plays. You see the Arkansas State fans that made the trip. Of course, we've been telling you how the ticket ratio works. It's 68% for the higher-seeded team in the first couple of rounds, in the first two rounds. After that, it's 50-50 from the Elite Eight onward. But Arkansas State, they have their fan base here. So another opportunity now for the Red Wolves, and a huge opportunity at that, with their defense only allowing 3 points. If they can score, they can take the lead. Here comes Applin. He's pressured. And open receiver for a three-yard gain. You see these Sun Belt teams, in order to try to combat with some of these bigger teams, they go for the spread, no huddle, and seems to work for them pretty well. At 10-2, the Arkansas State Red Wolves going up against the 11-1 Oklahoma State Cowboys. Third down and 5 for the Wolves. Applin is in shotgun once again. Inside handoff. Just short of the first down. And another three and out for Arkansas State. That was Derek Lawson on the carry. Fourth and one, and Arkansas State is forced to punt it. Here come the Cowboys. Cowboy football at the 42-yard line. We hope you've enjoyed the Bowl Championship Series up to this point. It's been a lot of fun filming and doing all these games. We hope you've had just as much fun watching it. As you can tell, a lot of time and effort has been put into this, and hope you guys enjoyed as much as we've had fun bringing these games to you. First and 10 for Oklahoma State. We saw Louisiana Tech when they played LSU earlier. Option play, that didn't work. They put up a fight with LSU. I mean, it was 17-14 at one point before LSU got a pick six and turned that thing around. So don't just assume that the bigger, badder team is just going to come in here with the blowout, because we've seen what the Sun Belt has done in years past. Second and 13, fakes it to Randall, and Whedon chucks it down the field, down to about the 40-yard line, brings up third down 5, and another opportunity for the Arkansas State Red Wolves to come up with a stop. Whedon has a man, and they do come up with the stop. Fourth and 3, Brandon Whedon was able to complete that to Josh Cooper. And they're going to attempt a 55-yard field goal. And it is good. How about the leg on Arkansas kicker Quinn Sharp? That is his first attempt at a field goal from 50-plus yards this season. Mike Gundy has the confidence. And once again, Oklahoma State has shockingly held to 2 field goals against this Ark State defense. And another opportunity. The Red Wolves have gone 3 and out on their 2 opening drives. Another opportunity for Ark State to try to move down the field and score. They would have the lead over Oklahoma State. Applin lines up in the gun. He takes the snap. He goes deep down the field looking for it all. Has an open man, and that is caught. That is caught. I think that was Josh Jarbo that caught it. I'm guessing maybe from the dreads. But unbelievably, here comes the Arkansas State Red Wolves. Ball at the 32-yard line. Applin, 5 wide receivers. He's lined up in the gun. He takes the snap. He's pressured. He has an open receiver. 7-yard pickup. That was Alan Muse with the catch. Applin again. Fakes it. Throws it. Caught by Jarbo at the 10-yard line. That is Josh Jarbo, number 3, who made the catch earlier. First and 10 for Arkansas State. Here come the Red Wolves. High snap by Applin. Applin throws it. And that's in there. That was Muse again. 1-yard gain. Second and 9. Intercepted. Oh, man. Ryan Applin made a mistake. Picked off by Oklahoma State cornerback Andre May. Here it is again. Applin. It was just simple pressure. I mean, they brought the pressure, and Applin got nervous, threw it, and May with his first interception of the year, and Oklahoma State avoids disaster on that drive. Back to Brandon Whedon. Whedon pitches it out to Randall. Randall's not going to get much. I'm impressed right now with this Arkansas State defense. I watched them earlier this year, and they played Virginia Tech, and they got absolutely hammered. They did have a lead in that game, though, at one point. So, Ark State knows how to compete with the big boys. Play action. Whedon. Incomplete. Justin Blackman drops it. Third down and 10. 0 for 3. Gundy cannot be happy with that. Whedon. Going way down the field. Intercepted. Intercepted by the Red Wolves. We're going the other way. Back up to the 45-yard line. Intercepted by Arkansas State. That was Don Jones with the pick. He was looking for Justin Blackman, and he overthrew him. Second interception. No, first interception of the year for Jones. Wow, the Red Wolves, they showed up here today. They're looking for the upset at Carter Stadium, Fort Worth, Texas. Oklahoma State 6, Arkansas State 0. Both teams have traded interceptions. Man, Justin Blackman, how rare is that from Brandon Wien to overthrow Justin Blackman? And not bad field position for the Red Wolves. 55 yards away from a touchdown. That one's going to go incomplete. Ryan Applin was looking for Dwayne Frampton on the play. Second down and 10 for Applin and the Wolves. Inside handoff. There's the give, and it's going to be a 2-yard pickup by Arkansas State running back Derek Lawson. Third down and 8 for the Wolves. Applin gets the call from the interim coach. Ryan Applin, first down. Is it enough? Yes, it is. That's a first down completion for the Red Wolves. We are now into Cowboy territory. Spread now. 5 wideouts. Nobody in the backfield. Bell Helicopter, Armed Forces Bowl. Ryan Applin's going to take off with it. He gets yanked down by the neck. Lucky that wasn't a horse collar grab. That was brought down by the man that had the interception earlier in the game. Second and 8. Lined up again in the spread with 5 wide receivers. No, he's going to bring it back to the backfield. So he'll have 4 wide. Applin will take off one more time. First down, Ryan Applin going to the house, and Applin is inside the 20-yard line. No huddle once again for the Red Wolves, and they could smell the end zone. They cannot afford to turn it over this time. Oklahoma State will not give you this many opportunities. Ryan Applin, why not run it again? Down to the 15. Bring everybody back. Second and 8. Red Wolves take to the sideline. Can the Sun Belt pull off an upset once again? Applin has no incomplete. He had his man. and he couldn't hang on to it. The Sun Belt Conference has been great in these first-round bowl games. They've never made it past the second round, but they are 3-2 in the first round. Pressured, Applin overthrew his wide receiver. The pressure came and knocked down quarterback Ryan Applin, and he had no other choice but to just throw it up, and he couldn't connect with his receiver, obviously, because of the pressure in his face. So the field goal will go through, and we're in the middle of a kicking battle. Brian Davis with the kick, yes. This is like the game of the century. Oh man, the kick return from Oklahoma State sets their team up with some really nice field position. Cornerback Justin Gilbert with the return. Arkansas State and Oklahoma State trading some field goals. We're about 3 minutes away from Boise, and Florida State kicking off on ESPN2. Hand off to Randall, and he's going to get a yard. Everyone back up to the line. Whedon floats it out there to Blackman. Third down and 4. I don't think they've converted on a third down yet in this game. Whedon pitches out to Joseph Randall. First down for Randall. Down to the 40, 41-yard line. Whedon throws it up. It's intercepted. It's intercepted once again by Arkansas State. Second INT of the game for Brandon Whedon. Oh, man. Picked off. That's Juwan Kilcrease. Juwan Kilcrease. Mike Gundy is asking Whedon, what the heck are you doing out there? First interception of the year for Kilcrease. Juwan Kilcrease from Nashville, Tennessee. Arkansas State will maintain possession and the momentum. Here come the Red Wolves. Ryan Applin connects with number 85. You all know him, of course. That's the tight end, Kendrick Murray. Second and 4. All this movement and motion. And that's in the hands of the receiver, but it's going to be 3 yards shy of the first down, and he was looking for Frampton on that play. Third down and 3 for Arkansas State. Here comes Applin. First down. Is that Jarbo? Josh Jarbo with the first down, and we are into Arkansas or Oklahoma State territory. 2 minutes to go, and the Red Wolves are moving at will right now on this Oklahoma State Cowboy defense. That one was overthrown, but it will stop the clock and it will slow some of the pace of the game down. It will give Ark State a chance to regroup. 6-3. Who would have thought it in the first half of this one? And 2 yard run by Lawson. Third down and 8. Incomplete. Looking for a short pass. Didn't work out for him. Do they go for it now? They will not. They will just punt it away. And it will bounce and roll just into the end zone. If he had a little bit more corner on that kick, that rolls out at the 1, and now you're really putting Oklahoma State in a rough predicament. Whedon in this offense trying to get things going. There's Randall, Joseph Randall. 13-yard run to bring up a first down, just under a minute 30 to play in the first half. Wide open receiver down to the 25-yard line. That was Whedon hooking up with Moore, Tracy Moore. Second and 11 to Randall. Randall gets brought down. Third down and 10 for Oklahoma State. Brandon Whedon and company. And they call a timeout, does Mike Gundy. Whedon has all day to throw. Incomplete. Incomplete. The field goal is no good, and Oklahoma State, no pun intended, but keeps shooting themselves right in the foot. 6 points. We've had three field goals in this game. Arkansas State. Both teams have had mistakes because you think about the interception thrown from Ark State. This could either be a Red Wolves lead or it could be a tie game right now. But I think everyone in Carter Stadium is on the edge of their seat at the Bell Helicopter Armed Forces Bowl. Ark State does have all their timeouts. They're going to use one. Attempting to get a field goal and at least tie this one up going into the half. There's a handoff to Dawson. That's enough for Arkansas State Red Wolves first down. Lawson, not Dawson. Derek Lawson. I combined the names for some reason. Here comes Ryan Applin rolling. Ryan Applin's going to run down to the 49. 10 seconds to go. They're trying to save that last timeout. And they burn it. Nobody was set, so depending on how quickly they do this, they can maybe get the field goal off or they can just try to go for the score. Applin is going for the score towards the end zone. Hail Mary, it's incomplete. Looking for Josh Jarbo. What a first half this was. We got Boise State and Florida State kicking off on ESPN2 in just a few moments, but do not go away from this one. Brandon Whedon and the Oklahoma State Cowboys are on the ropes. It is 6-3 in Fort Worth. Second half is about to kick off, and no, that score does not deceive you. Oklahoma State 6 and Arkansas State 3. Let's look at game tracks for those of you just tuning in. Ryan Applin, while he's been under some pressure today, he's done really well. That was his one error of the game when Arkansas State could have really turned it their way, but Ark State has had two interceptions of their own. It's been all about the defense early on. 6-3. Two Brandon Whedon interceptions for the number three team in the nation. And Whedon finds a wide open receiver way in to Arkansas State territory, and he hooked up with his man Josh Cooper for a first down. They are now at the 40. Whedon looking for it all, overthrows his wide receiver, incomplete. Brandon Whedon says, what the heck is going on right now? Second and 10. Over the middle, and that's going to be a first down for the Cowboys. Bringing everyone up to the line with the no huddle just inside the 30. Lined up in the pistol. Here comes the pressure. Brandon Whedon, though, is so quick, finds Justin Blackman for the first down. They brought the blitz, and it came to bite the Red Wolves. Now they're under center. Whedon floats it out there, incomplete. Second and 10. For the end zone, just short. They're moving, but Arkansas State is making them fight for every single yard. Tracy Moore with that catch. And now on the option to Randall. No dice. Second and goal. They're going to let Whedon throw it. He screens it out there. Touchdown, Tracy Moore, and touchdown, Oklahoma State, the first one of the game. Beautifully designed play, stacked the line. You had two wide receivers break from the route and go to the far side of the field. And that left two options for Brandon Whedon with this extra point. It's a 10-point game. Arkansas State is fighting with Oklahoma State in this one. Apparently that was the Lowe's touchdown drive. How do the Red Wolves respond? They've had some moments of brilliance on offense. They've only had 3 points to show for it. They can move down and score, though. Can really put some pressure back on Oklahoma State. They give it to Lawson. Look at Lawson roll. Here comes Lawson all the way down inside the 40-yard line, down to the 41. Great run by Lawson. Applin is pressured. He gets the ball away, though, into the waiting arms of Muse, who's been all over the field today. Applin will run it. That's going to be a first down for the Wolves into Oklahoma State territory. You got to love the fight in Arkansas State. Who says these guys don't deserve to be national champions? They've only got 2 losses. They're 10-2. Who's to say this isn't the best team in the nation? Applin is going to get brought down. Cornerback blitz on both sides. He ate turf. In on the sack was Oklahoma State cornerback Justin Gilbert, and then also on the other side was Broderick Brown. Second down, they give it to Lawson, and he's going to get tackled. Lawson was brought down by Levy. Third down and 17 for Arkansas State. Applin heaves it. First down throw incomplete. Arkansas State will have to punt it away. Oh, you can feel it. They are giving their heart and their effort out there against the bigger, stronger Oklahoma State Cowboys. Oklahoma State, though, for the same token, they're giving their hearts. You can tell. And Ark State's bringing in Oklahoma State. They're struggling with it. 5 wideouts for Brandon Whedon. Over the middle, Whedon has his open receiver, and that's going to be a first down for the Cowboys. Ball at the 36-yard line. Whedon is pressured. He gets it out there to Randall, I want to say. No, that was not out to Randall. That was out to Cooper. I thought he pitched out to the running back, but here comes the Ark State defense, and Arkansas State able to blitz and pressure the number 3 ranked team in the nation. Second and 13. Brandon Whedon fires it in there, and that's into Arkansas State territory for a first down. I wish our ESPN stat box at the bottom would pop up and tell you who caught these things, but unfortunately it doesn't seem to want to work this year. Maybe next year, EA. Whedon will take it. Give it to Randall. No, he won't. He'll hang on to it. He's got so much time, he throws it. And that one was tossed into triple coverage. Whedon is flirting with interception number 3 of the game if he keeps throwing passes like that. 2nd and 10. All data throw incomplete off of the back of Cooper. Cooper wasn't even looking for it. 3rd down and 10. Only 1 for 6 on the money down for Oklahoma State. Is that in there? No, incomplete. Incomplete. I thought he had it. And the Red Wolves will hold. Fourth down, and Arkansas State gets it back. Horrible punt. He just didn't even try. He kicked it right out of the back of the end zone. At least try to get it out at the 1 or something. 80 yards. They're looking for the big red end zone. 80 yards away from them. They're going to give it on the wide receiver sweep to Jarbo. And he's going to get brought down and is able to pick up 1. Applin and company, though, right back at work. 4 wide receivers. We got 3 set out on the near side. Keep your eye down there. Applin is pressured and he's able to get it out to Lawson. Not much effort. That was a halfback slip screen. It didn't work out for him. So 3rd and 11 as they lose 2 on the play. And Applin's going to have to go deep down the field. Again, 3 wide receivers set out. They give it to Lawson on the draw play. It fools them. How about that play call from the interim coach to go with a draw play on 3rd and 11 with the season on the line? It works out for him. Ryan Applin's going to run it. Here comes Applin. That defensive, the linebacker, didn't even see Applin going. He was looking, and next thing you knew, Applin blew right past him. 1st and 10. Applin, option, hangs on to it. Probably the probably the right decision. Applin does have 600 yards rushing this season, 9 touchdowns on the ground. It'll be 2nd and 12. They give it to Lawson, and Lawson's going to get 1. He's been able to break through with a couple of nice runs, but Oklahoma State's done a fine job of stopping them here today. 3rd down and 11. We get the 3 wide set to the far side now for the Red Wolves. Here comes the pressure, and down goes Ryan Applin. Quarterback sack for the Oklahoma Cowboys, cornerback Andre May. And that'll force the Red Wolves to have to punt it away. Oklahoma State could potentially start to put this game away if Brandon Whedon can lead a drive that results in 6 points. There's a fumble. Oh my goodness. That's Arkansas State football. We're going to the house. Touchdown, Red Wolves. Touchdown, Arkansas State Red Wolves. What a change of momentum. Never mind that touchdown drive now. Nathan Harold, the linebacker, picked up the fumble and ran it in for the score. Oh my goodness, we now have a 4-point game on our hands. Yeah, Josh Cooper was supposed to return it. He fumbled it. With pressure in his face, he didn't call for the onside kick. Wow. Now more than ever, Brandon Whedon needs to lead his team on that touchdown drive. No, it's no more they can put this game away with the touchdown drive. They need to roll down the field and score, or else they're in danger of going home. The winner of this game will meet either Oklahoma or Houston in the second round. Everyone was talking. We were already talking about the SEC Championship Part 2 with Georgia and LSU in the Liberty Bowl. People were talking about Bedlam Part 2. It might not happen. Oklahoma State's got a roll right now. Joseph Randle, though, can help them out. Great run by Joseph Randle. Hurdling defenders. Awesome blocking all the way. Don't get too cocky now. Don't bang your offensive lineman and force a concussion. We're heading into the fourth quarter. It is a three-point football game between number 3 and number 30. The Sun Belt champions and the Big 12 champions going toe-to-toe. The Sun Belt Conference is 3-0, or 3-2 all time in the first round. They're looking to make it 4-2. Oklahoma State's been to the BCS playoffs 3 times. They've been to the Final Four once, the Elite Eight twice. This could be their worst finish ever. Let's see what happens. Oh, he's able to get it out to Randle somehow. Or got it to somebody. Second down and 11. The pressure is on right now for Oklahoma State, Mike Gundy and company. You've got to be more impressed with the fact that Oklahoma State, they've been held to 1 touchdown, 2 field goals by this Arkansas State defense. This is a high-powered Oklahoma State offense. 5 wide receivers for Brandon Whedon on third down. Whedon going for it all. He finds his man to the 20-yard line. 5 wide receivers, and that's how good Oklahoma State is. Wow, Brandon Whedon. They're at the 20-yard line now. 4 wideouts. Open receiver, Cooper. Pushed out of bounds, second down and 1. Do they give it to Randle? Do they throw it? What are they going to do in this situation? They pitch it to Randle, and he's going to be stopped short, so it's 3rd and 2, and you don't want to be held to a field goal in this situation if you're Oklahoma State. You also don't want to turn the ball over. You also got to get your whole team to come back. This is a really weak shot at a no huddle, as everyone just kind of jogging back at this point. Whedon throws it, end zone, touchdown, Oklahoma State, Tracy Moore. Oh, and the Cowboys may have just saved their season. Wow. The extra point will make it a 10-point game for the Red Wolves. Kick is away. Kick is good. Oklahoma State sneaking by on that drive. Ark State looking to pull off the upset. They have time. They have 3 timeouts. They got 10 points to overcome. Oklahoma State, though, says we're not going to let it happen. Perhaps they were maybe looking ahead to that Bedlam showdown. Might not even be a Bedlam showdown. Houston could easily pull off the win against Oklahoma, especially with the way Oklahoma's played the last couple of weeks. 2nd and 9 now for Ryan Applin and company. They give it to Lawson again, and Lawson's going to get them 6 on the run. 3rd down and 3. First down for the Red Wolves. That was wide receiver Stockmeyer. Applin's going to go down on the sack. That's a loss of 5. They got to bring everyone back. 2nd and 15. Here goes Ryan Applin. He's going to run it. And down he goes. Didn't work out for him there either. 3rd down and 13. Got to come up with the completion right now. Your season is on the line. You put up a heck of a fight against number 3 in the nation. Chaplin, incomplete. Fourth down and 13 in the Red Wolves' season will come down to one final play. They're going to punt it away. Wow. They're going to let the defense try to hold. I thought for sure maybe they'd go for it. They're going to punt it away. Maybe hoping for Brandon Wheaton's third interception. They have all their timeouts. Surely they're going to use them. All right, so I take that back. Ark State season will not rest on one final play. They're going to leave it in the hands of their defense. Cooper with the run. Cooper gets 3 yards. That's timeout number one for Arkansas State. Second and 7. And timeout number 2 is burned. Third down and 3. Hold them again. And this is a successful decision to punt it. Cooper will take it. First down. There goes Josh Cooper. And that might be the end for the Red Wolves year. Lots of blunders, though. When you think about it, the turnovers, 2 interceptions from Whedon, the punt that ended up in a touchdown for Oklahoma State, this is issues they have to address because next week they're either going to be going up against Oklahoma or Houston, 2 very good teams. And Whedon will go down, 3rd down and 10. The Bell Helicopter Armed Forces Bowl. They saw a really good one. And there's still time tonight for everyone to flip over, see, catch some of Boise and Florida State on ESPN2 at the Mako Bowl. 1 final run, and that should seal it for the Cowboys. Well, they decide to throw it. Well, whatever works for them. They get it out to Tracy Moore. This is Friday. Tomorrow, it's Saturday. It's where college football shines. You're going to have Alabama going out. Let's get the schedule for you tomorrow. You got, of course, Alabama. They're going to be going at it at about 4:30. It's number 2 in the nation against NIU. Arkansas in the Music City Bowl. We got the Oklahoma-Houston game at noon. The Kraft Fight Hunger Bowl with Stanford. I mean, we got number 2 and number 4 at 4:30 and at 8. Then we got the Insight Bowl. We wrap it all up with the Christmas Bowl. And that'll be it for round number 1. Arkansas State put up one heck of a fight. They lost to Oklahoma State by just 10 points. The Cowboys with lots of issues to address going forward, but they sneak by the Red Wolves of Arkansas State in this one, 20-10. Let's see what your play of the game was. If I had to guess, it would be the Tracy Moore touchdown, because I can't think of any better play to put this game out of reach. Well, how was that sack? That random sack is the play of the game? I'm sorry, that was the worst play of the game decision I've ever seen. I don't know how that sack in the first quarter resulted in play of the game, but whatever. Player of the game, Andre May. 2 sacks, 2 tackles for losses, 6 tackles in the game. I almost say give it to Tracy Moore, but May comes through for his team. And the Red Wolves disappointed, but I'm sure they're happy with the way they performed. So the Sun Belt, they'll fall to 3-3 in first-round games. That's still really impressive. They're at 500 for this conference. And there you see the play of the game. Once again, I still understand how it was the play of the game, but this was the game. Now, that was the first touchdown of the game for Brandon Whedon and company. The one where they started. Here's the big play. Look at that. I mean, this is when we were all starting to get on the edge of our seat and be like, okay, things are getting interesting now, but this was the one that won it for him. Look at Moore. Tracy Moore just shakes the defender, I mean, that's all Moore on that one. You got to credit him. Don Jones on the coverage, but Moore just out-juked him, got into the end zone, and that was a touchdown. There's a snapshot one more time of that great play for the Red Wolves on the punt. Final game stats. Brandon Whedon, 25 of 38, 258, two touchdowns, two interceptions. Applin, 13 to 23, 122, no touchdowns, but he had an interception. For the running game, Randall, 9 runs, 69 yards. And for Lawson, 13 attempts for 56 yards. Receiving core, you see Muse. Jarbo led his team, but you had Stockmeyer and Murray. Each did pretty well on their team. For Oklahoma State, Tracy Moore, 7 receptions, 91 yards, 2 grabs. Cooper did his part. So did Anderson and Justin Blackmon, 2 grabs. And then for defense, I mean, they got to Applin. They did well. Andre May, 9 tackles, 6 solo, 2 sacks, and an interception. Kilcrease on the other side, interception. Edwards had the interception. But other than that, let's take a look at the team stats. I'm sure they're pretty even. First downs, 14 to 11. Oklahoma State had about 100 more yards of total offense. Passing yards, Oklahoma State had them there. But, I mean, it was close. You look at third down efficiency, Ark State did better. The red zone, I mean, I think this game would be different if Arkansas State didn't throw that interception on that drive. And that's what happened, too, when LSU game, LSU and Louisiana Tech game, I mean, they were driving, and that big shoulder tackle caused the fumble, and that turned that game around. So those interceptions going down, driving down is what cost some of these teams. Turnovers, 3 of them for Oklahoma State. They're lucky to win this game with 3 turnovers. Fumble, 2 interceptions, and the rest you could read on your own. All right, let's take a look at the updated polls. What a fun and wild game.